Can a story be equal parts exciting and equal parts revolting? Clear in its messaging and yet exhaustingly non-committal? Have you watched Kuruthi yet? Streaming on Amazon Prime Video, Kuruthi is a Malayalam language film directed by Manu Warrier. Technically, it is a home invasion movie, which is an extremely versatile genre. I mean, aap khud hi dekh lo, there's a thriller like Kaun, Urmila Matondkar wali. It can be a comedy like the Home Alone movies. It can be horror, jaise Aronofsky's Mother, post-apocalyptic, anything with zombies, where essentially your home, your safe space becomes someone else's playground. Manu Warrier and writer Anish Parayal go the thriller route. A cop and convict enter a home in the middle of the night, and one by one, more people keep joining in, some willingly, some forcefully, through the course of the same night. But some writing choices na really set Kuruthi apart from other thriller home invasion movies, like say David Fincher's Panic Room. Actually, Quentin Tarantino's Hateful Eight would be a better parallel to draw. Sabse pehle toh, there's a structure, the planned way each character is introduced into the home where the action plays out. It's captured masterfully by cinematographer Abhinandan Ramanujam. It's all very spaghetti western, you know, a questionable cop with power, then a seemingly innocent neighbor, phir ek vigilante and its sidekick. Sabki individual motivations hai, backstories hai, they're intertwining, and eventually they're forcing the unwilling hosts to become part of the whole shebang also. And the second is the glaring commentary on the divisiveness of prevalent societal structures put in place by oppressors. Hateful Eight was set in 1877, when a black man was not just a bounty hunter transferring a person or looking for a person, but also had personal angst, which becomes his ultimate motive behind everything that's happening. The initial task is then pushed to the sidelines, and as we get to know the characters one by one through their stories and lives, we question that time's laws and rules and how they contributed to the world, or at least America as it existed then, 1877. Today, Kuruthi's main conflict hinges on a religiously motivated murder of a Muslim man by an upper caste Hindu youth who's been radicalized into believing reservations are evil and other things like generations have to avenge atrocities committed by Shahjahan. The cop transporting this guy from point A to B with the unplanned halt in the middle is also Hindu, but his plans are rapidly failing, raising the question ki are our current systems even working? This then spirals very believably into chaos, where regular people take up arms against each other who otherwise would have spent their entire lives never even thinking about the differences in the gods they worship. Dekho, if you have paid any attention to current affairs, you know religious violence is raging across the world. One glance at the news and I get anxiety which lasts the whole day uske baad. Anish Palayal's writing takes this very real anxiousness already residing within all of us, which Manu Warrier then multiplies manifold, creating sequences with mounting tension aided by shockingly talented actors. Roshan Mathew as Ibrahim is arguably the lead actor of this movie, despite Prithviraj Sukumaran's presence. You see, he gets just the right amount of vulnerability to be the underdog. But when it comes to stepping into the action, Ibrahim still remains real, despite the most dramatic of situations around him. It's just some excellent acting. Speaking of, how incredible is the 75-year-old actor Mammu Koya as Musa Khan? Having never watched anything he's ever been in, I was highly entertained watching him play a retired Chandan smuggler, who is now just your garden variety old miserable patriarch, until the climax, when things change. And Prithviraj Sukumaran is great too, except he has way too many unnecessary low angle, angsty, dramatic shots, perhaps overcompensating for his lack of screen time, because he appears in this film 45 minutes into the screenplay. Shrinda plays the only female character in the movie, Sumati, and is also just stunningly good. Kuruthi goes out of its way to not place the blame on Hinduism or Islam, maybe not even people who choose to practice religion. Isliye I was bewildered ki kehna kya chahte ho, kyunki kuch to aap keh rahe ho. The cinematography, set design, acting, music, it's all on point. It's very high production value, very evocative. So what are the emotions you're trying to evoke? Jab bhi lagta hai ki koi upstand liya hai, quickly it changes tone, which I'm assuming is by design. So is this about opportunistic evil politicians? Is it about rampant global Islamophobia? There's a dialogue in it which says, a spark of hate is all you need to ignite a raging fire. But the film doesn't quite commit to exploring the kindling which the spark is igniting. There's rhetorical questions like, am I the prey? Are you the prey? which sound good when a character says them out loud in a forest, invoking a feeling ki jungle raj hi chal raha hai. Par na aapko answer pata hai, na movie answer dene mein interested hai. So it's just kind of annoying. I mean, the title says Guru Thi, the holy slaughter. And the film opens with a scene where a young girl is sad her goat will be slaughtered by her loving Muslim father. So is Guru Thi encouraging violence? Is it saying men are also like cattle, raised within society rules only for personal gain of a few? Like I said, it's zara bewildering. Have you watched the movie on Amazon Prime Video? What did you think of it? Okay, now for my favorite thing, relation mein recommendation. Home invasion genre mein, this one's gonna be a little roundabout, so stay with me. One of the highest selling, most popular true crime novels ever written is about a home invasion by Truman Capote. The book is called In Cold Blood. It's been adapted to cinema, a 1967 movie by the same name. But what I loved was Philip Seymour Hoffman playing author Truman Capote during the 5 to 6 years he spent working on this home invasion true crime novel In Cold Blood. That movie, which won Philip Seymour Hoffman his only Oscar, is called Capote. I don't know where you can watch it in India right now, but if you can, check it out and you can watch me talk about the movie in detail right here. Okay, like I said, it's zara roundabout, but you get what I'm saying, no? We're friends, no? Okay, chalo, bye. Subscribe kar le channel ko, please.